Have you always lived in Rome?
Yes, I have.
Okay. Can you tell me a little bit about how your family ended up here?
Yes, my mother is from Rome, and my dad lived just over the county line in Gordon County, and he did some work in Rome, and they met, fell in love, and had two beautiful children, me being the youngest.
Okay. Well, that's pretty cool. So thank you for sharing that with me. As you know, I'm not originally from Rome, but I have really enjoyed getting to work here for the past 5 years. And it's a really cool community, a lot of great people. Anyway, right now, I currently live in a two-story brick home. Would you mind telling me about what kind of home you live in?
I'd love to share that with you. I live in a split-level, four-sided brick home. It is a three-bedroom, two-bath. One bedroom is converted into a home office, and it's got an outdoor patio, and we enjoy our outdoor space, outdoor living.
Okay. All right. Can you tell me, are you a renter or do you own your home?
I'm an owner.
Okay. All right. Do you have an approximate date that you actually moved in?
Yes, I moved in June 29th of this year.
Oh, wow. So not too long ago. Do you have rooftop solar for your home?
No, I do not.
Okay. Tell me why you don't have rooftop solar. Did you make the decision or was the decision made for you?
Well, the house did not come with it, and it's probably not that cost effective to put it in, so we went with what was already existing rather than reinventing the wheel.
Okay. All right. If you had the option, would you put rooftop solar on your home?
I would have to look at the cost. In my mind, I just think it's too expensive. It might not be, but I'm just uneducated on that. I would consider it if it was economical.
Okay, so you would consider it if it was economical.
Yes.
To be honest with you, I do think that you still can have power outages, so I don't think that you constantly have power regardless of weather and things like that. I, however, am not exactly an expert on that. But that is a great, great question.
Thank you for your honesty.
Right now, I'd like to talk to you a bit about rooftop solar adoption in general. So here is a map of the United States. Okay. And here's a pen for you. All right. Where do you think people have the most rooftop solar energy on their homes? Could you draw that on the map? Where you think the most people have rooftop solar? Okay, is that?
Right there.
Okay. All right. What makes that community so different from people in Rome?
Well, it's so stinking cold up there, and I figure I want to have real electricity and solar electricity and any kind of electricity I can get my hands on.
Okay. Let's also talk about the state of Georgia. So here's a map of the state of Georgia.
Oh, yes, I see.
Okay. In what community in Georgia do you think people have the most rooftop solar on their homes?
Well, geez, I really never had thought about that. Let me think. South Georgia's hot. Northeast Georgia's cold. I'm going to say South Georgia for no particular reason.
Okay. So, tell me, why do you think the people from South Georgia are so different from people in Rome?
Well, possibly because Rome is not a big city metro like Atlanta, but there is more open land there, and perhaps solar energy might be more efficient in the acreage that they have in South Georgia.
Okay. What about most of your close friends here in Georgia? Do they have rooftop solar?
To my knowledge, nobody I know has rooftop solar.
Okay. Do you know why they don't?
It's not built in today's homes unless it's specified. And I don't know that people are aware or educated on solar energy, and they just go with the natural energy that we all know and love.
Okay. All right. Is there anything else that you would like to add about solar energy or about this process?
Well, I know what I'm... No, I don't think so.
Okay. All right.